Hi all. So this time we're going to talk a little bit about temperature, which is obviously one of the very important things in the game, and it can give you lots of trouble if you don't know how to deal with it. And temperature comes in various things in the game, in various different areas inside the game. It affects liquids, it affects gases, pretty much affects everything, the environment. And the thing is, everything in the game is temperature sensitive, as in normal life, really. For example, humans, around a temperature of like 55, 60 or more Celsius, they are gonna start, pretty much burning. They're gonna feel bad. Specifically in the game, they overheat and they have to go to the med bay, for instance. Likewise, when the temperature is very low, it has a similar effect. And another thing that also matters quite some, we have some polluted oxygen here. So another thing that matters a lot is examining the temperature around your base. So initially, you start with a very nice biome here, which everything is super cozy. But around you, there are other biomes that are coming to get you. And what I mean by that is the fact that whenever you see something that's hot around you, if there is no abyssalite that's actually acting as an insulator, like you see, for instance, let's examine this location over here. So over here, for instance, this is a heated area, but there is abyssalite here. And that's why you notice that there is the heated area here, but in between the abyssalite, there's a normally heated area and another normally heated area. So this thing in between, which is the abyssalite, is acting as an insulator, which means that it captures the heat. It doesn't allow it to go from one place to another. And that's super, super important for your base. Why? Because let's picture this location here, for instance, which is around 35 degrees Celsius. So as in real life, whatever is getting heated here will slowly creep in to your base, very, very slowly. It will take a lot of time. So in order to avoid that and to pretty much make it impossible for the heat to come in, you have to insulate specific parts of your base. And as you notice here, for instance, I have created specific tiles that are reddish. You see here, actually, in the heated overlay, you can see it better. These are reddish here, and while these ones are actually normal in color. Likewise here. Why does that happen? This happens because any heat that comes in from this area is actually trapped inside the tile and it doesn't actually transfer inside my base. And that's extremely important to keep your base cool, obviously. And you see here, for instance, that there is abyssalite, and that's the only location where my tiles are actually still in their normal color, because it's abyssalite that acts as an insulator over here. If I remove that, then these tiles would also get hotter. But they would capture the heat. They would actually capture the heat from coming inside the base. Now, you notice that machines are also emitting heat, and obviously some machines emit more, some machines emit less. But regardless, any machine that emits heat actually emits heat in the surroundings. So you see here it starts in this location and slowly starts spreading a little bit. A little bit. As time passes, it will be spreading more and more. And that's why, generally speaking, after you are done with research and stuff, it's generally a good idea to move the machines out of your base and move the batteries out of your base. As normally I'm moving batteries and power somewhere around here, for instance. But it's a matter of preference, really. But I have created a separate tutorial for explaining the way I'm doing power. But this is what you need to know, right? The fact that anything that emits heat actually will continue emitting heat around it and will continue heating your base forever, really. And there are also some other ways around some other mechanisms around cooling your base. Obviously, for instance, if you can see here, the water here acts sort of like an insulator, so even if there was heat around here, it would stop around here because the water, it wouldn't surpass the water. So it kind of acts as a sort of like a foam, think about it like this, in this game. But this is obviously not the most effective thing. You normally have to insulate. That's the best way to go about it. And I probably eventually have to insulate around here also once I use the water or so. But also remember that insulation doesn't mean that you're actually heating the area. So if actually heat passes over here and you insulate, then you're actually you should start insulating from here, not from here, because it will already be hot. If you actually want to cool things, then you need something like a wizard, which I don't think I have a cold biome that I can show you in this specific game, because it's actually a new game that I started for showing you the heat stuff. But in the cold biome, there are some plants that are called wizards, and they emit pretty much. You know, they allow you to cool locations, so they emit sort of like a cool air around them. And you can put them in a location, let's say in a farm, and it will actually make it cooler. And so it can potentially help the growth of plants, for instance. Generally speaking, it's also used for cooling down liquids, for example, or pipes, actually, not liquids, because liquids are almost impossible to cool in the game. It's very tough. So yeah, you can use it to cool oxygen, for example, as it passes through pipes, or cool liquid as it passes through pipes again, but not only not as a body of liquid so much. Obviously, if you check around you, and you should always be wary of what exists around you, so that you know where you have to insulate. In this case, in this specific game. You see, for instance, that the swamp biome is a little bit hotter than normal, but not extremely hot. It's this kind of biome, actually, that has the chlorine and hydrogen that tends to be the hottest, apart from magma, obviously. But, you always have to keep in mind where you're actually digging and what kind of machines you're making. Or obviously, you don't want to be making farms here, for example, because they pretty much won't grow. Unless you have like a massive amount of wizards, which you don't really want to spend for no reason, really, right? So over here, for instance, would be a nice way to use this biome, for instance, in some situations, to cool it down pipes if you want. Now that it's a little bit tedious, because as you are cooling down the pipes, they are actually heating the area around them. So eventually, you'd have to distract them and rebuild them a little bit, outwards or inwards, just relocate them a little bit, because again, anything that emits heat will eventually melt things down, even if we're talking about the ice biome. Always bear that in mind. There's always some compensation for what you're doing. So these are the basic ideas. Just remember that everything has consequences around heat. Building machines are heating stuff up also. So always be wary of where you are building your things. You really don't want to flood your main base with machines. You actually want to remove machines from your middle base, from your main base, and insulate the area around. That's what you should be doing, so that you always have a place that's cool, at least one place that's cool in your base. That's like very, very cozy. In case things go wrong. So yeah, I'm looking to get some more abyssalite and just insulate the areas here. I did get some, actually, so I really want to insulate. And again, I shouldn't be doing it here, because that's already hot. I actually want to protect the hot part from coming in my base, so I'm doing it here, right on the edge. This is where you should be doing it. And I should probably do it here also, because yeah, this is a little bit more. This is a little bit tougher here, because there is also this building over here, this hidden area. The good thing is there's a abyssalite here, kind of protects me. I may not even want to dig that. I have to think about it. Although, not the whole. Actually, yeah, there's a abyssalite over here, so it will protect the area, actually, as you see, and it won't emit heat from that side, as long as I don't break it, right? If I dig into that, it will still emit heat. But right now, abyssalite is actually saving me from that. So yeah, basically that's and the other thing that you also need to notice that there's some of the materials are actually emitting heat on their own, like dirt, for example, is very very hot. So always bear that in mind also, that it can actually heat some of your areas over here. Now the mass is very small, so it doesn't really affect the base that much, but it's good to know about it. And obviously your duplicates also have heat with them. So yeah, these are the most important things I believe about heat. Again, it's super important to use the overlay just to know where you are with heat, and just to see whether you have insulated the important areas. You really need to insulate. For instance, here you don't really want to insulate anything, right? You see, you have an abyssalite layer here, an abyssalite layer here. So you know, heat can only come from this place, and that would take ages. Probably not ever arrive actually. So yeah, just be wary of your surroundings. That's the gist of it. And once you know that you can use abyssalite, it can, you know, you can actually keep your cool, your base cool forever. And the other thing that I want you to notice is that you notice that there is a tile and an insulated tile. The insulated tile is exactly the same thing with the tile. If both are used, are made with abyssalite, there's no difference. The only difference is actually that it costs more for some reason. And it's a little bit different in a visual presentation. It actually looks like this. But it actually has the exact same effect as you'll see here. The abyssalite, this is an abyssalite tile, which is normal. I always use this one. Never use the insulated, it makes no sense. You're actually burning materials for no reason. So you'll see that the thermal conductivity is basically zero. So it actually won't conduct heat. It won't conduct heat at all. So it's pretty perfect. So yeah, that's it. Hopefully that that actually gives you some good ideas and some knowledge around the heat. It's really not that hard to manage, as long as you know the basic stuff, the abyssalite, the insulated tiles, wishboards, how to cool down on pipes and all that. And again, playing the game is actually the best way to practice those, obviously. But it pays to know. Oh, and the other thing that I actually forgot to mention, which is also super important and I should have, whenever you're piping things inside your base, let's say that you want to create a system inside here to send water to your plants, that water has to be cold, in a very cool temperature, because if you are passing, first of all, the plants won't grow if you are passing them, if you are passing warm water to them, or hot water, I should say, they just won't grow. And also, let's say that you have sours, right? And like sours, and you don't really care of what type of water you pass. It could be super hot. Your duplicates won't mind. But the problem is that if you pass the plumbing, let's say from this ladder, the heat that comes from the pipes will emit to your plants, and they will actually have trouble growing. So you really shouldn't be, shouldn't be sending anything that's heated inside your base. Make sure that your pipes that are passing from locations inside your base, even from edge locations sometimes, are cool. Super, super important. You really don't want your base to fry because you're getting steam geyser water inside your base without cooling it. Don't do it. So yeah, that's it. Thanks for watching, and I hope that this was helpful for you. And I'll see you soon in the next video. Bye.